I've gone 9 times. Over 3 years, I've spent probably a total of about 4 months there. The thing that really spurred everything on was earthquake. And I went back for 2 weeks at earthquake. That was a tremendous experience and showed me how great the need was. There are more Haitian physicians in Canada than there are in Haiti. And 95% of the Haitian physicians that are in Haiti, which is way, way short of being enough, are in Port-au-Prince. That means 5% of the Haitian physicians are in the rest of the country. Transportation is very difficult. You know, people coming from the hills, many of them have to walk to get to a central place where they can get a tap. Some people come 4 and 5 hours to come to see us. We saw over 700 people in the clinic area and did over 85 procedures. To severe trauma. We had one case in which a 27-year-old had been stabbed in the chest. Our general surgeon happened to be a thoracic surgeon, and we were able to take him directly to the OR, and 6 days later he walked out. We had a lady who had a hysterectomy the time before, and she now was not bleeding, and she brought us a goat the next trip as a thank you gift, which, unless you've been there, you don't understand how big of a gift that is. It's a huge gift, and I was almost in tears because this was so big of a gift, and unless you've been in that environment, you don't understand what she was doing and what this meant to her. But we have cases, unfortunately, that we can't do anything with. I've had to tell parents with young children that their one-year-old was not going to make age two because they were already in heart failure from a heart defect that could have very easily been treated in the United States. People are very thankful for us being there. You know, you feel very sad when you have to tell somebody that they're going to die. For them, ladies with metastatic breast cancer that are in pain, and we try to give them as much pain medicine as we can to help relieve their pain. We're not going to be able to do anything to save them. We have so many things that we take so much for granted, whether it be just drinking water, very availability of food, simple shelter, all the things that we take for granted. Our next trip will be March 22nd through April 3rd. It'll be a 12-day trip.